we have 20 seats behind me that are reserved for our blind fans. They come to a match on match days and they're all given an earpiece so they can listen to radio commentary. The time you come to a match, you see most of the match, they take their earpiece out because the regular fans sat in front of them are turning around telling them what's happening on the pitch. Good atmosphere here on match days. Now, on a match day, when we get 75, 76,000 fans here, most of them are Man United fans. But for league matches, the opposition are allowed to bring 3,100 fans. So when we play Man City, Chelsea, Liverpool, etc., the opposition fans will actually be sat in these seats here behind you. They're allowed to bring 3,100 for a league match, but if they come match, League Cup match or European match, they can't bring more. We played Middlesbrough in the League Cup this season, and we had just over 10,000 Middlesbrough fans here. 3,000 here, the rest in the seats at the top of the standard. Now behind you, you see the glass windows. We've got private boxes here at Old Trafford. They allow people to sit in there to eat and drink. There's televisions in there. The smallest box holds 5 people and costs just under £20,000 for the season. The biggest box on the Stretford End holds 16 people and that's up to £30,000 for the season. Anybody's got that money in the pocket, they want to book it down? Now, has anybody heard of a player called Wayne Rooney? No, nobody's heard of Wayne Rooney. I was thinking somebody else. But wait, yeah, Wayne Rooney's family have a private box. This season, they've started the box at the Stretford End. But up until last season, Wayne Rooney's private box was the one up there, S07, the one second to the right from that booth. Now, Wayne's family, Colleen and his two sons, regularly come to the match to watch Wayne play football. And you'll notice the past few years, when Wayne scored a goal here at the scoreboard end, remember the goal against City?
Yes.
I've got to mention it. Well, whenever Wayne scores a goal here at this end, he never runs to that corner flag, he always ran to this corner flag. I'm sure so his wife could take his photograph. Must be. I'm sure. One or two of our players have boxes. I believe Michael Carrick's got one on the Stretford End as well. But all our players do have to pay for them. They're not giving them as a privilege. They do charge for them. Now, looking at our pitch, you'll see that our pitch is actually raised up. Underneath our pitch, we've got 18 miles of plastic piping. So in winter time, if we do get any snow and frost on the pitch, we can run hot water in that piping to melt any snow and frost so we don't get any games postponed. Peter was mentioning about our pitch being 3% artificial and 97% real ryegrass. Well, along this touch line, you can see that it's 100% artificial. And behind the goal, it's 100% ryegrass. But there is a mix actually on the pitch. So the wheel up there, that's stadium control. We've got 168 cameras around our stadium, inside and out, and they're monitored for those screens inside the stadium control. Further along the stand, underneath the stand, you can see the television gantry. When Man United is on television, we have 7 cameras up in that gantry, and 7 cameras and 21 people. The cameras are hoisted up from the ground, the 21 people walk along the inside of the roof, and then down into that gantry. And when you see Man United on television, and you see Gary Lineker in the studio, or Paul Scholes, Roy Keane, etc., they're actually in the 3 booths at the bottom. You can see 2 grey booths and a brick-built booth at the bottom of the south stand. They're actually television commentary boxes. Okay. Has anybody got any questions before we move on? No?